For making a customer invoice, we go to sale and sale and return menu. On this screen, we first load the items. We can load items in different ways. One is to scan all the items through a barcode reader. The other is we type the item code and press enter. So item is loaded. We can also call up the item list. This list item and list is displayed. We load the required items. For displaying the item list, we can also press F1 or F6 keys. The same list will appear and we can load the items. Once all the items are loaded, we can go to the payment screen. On this screen, the cash paid by the customer is entered here. The balance which is payable to the customer is displayed here and we press save. To print the receipt, customer receipt, we press this button. On this screen, we press this blue print button to send the receipt to the printer. If we want to make changes to already made receipt, we press this search tab and press the search button. The recently made receipt will appear. We can select the receipt, double click it, or press the edit receipt button. It will be loaded. We can make the desired changes. Again, go to the payment screen, make changes here also, and press update. All the changes will be reflected and receipt will be saved. Now we look at some of the other features of this screen. On this screen, we see that one is the payment button, which we have seen. Another is the quick save cash option, which means if we don't want to go to the next screen and quickly save the invoice, we just press this cash button and system will save the invoice. On this screen, we see a salesperson box. This will bring up the salesperson list. These are the employee list. We press this and now this salesperson will be attached to the invoice which is being made. Another option is to make an invoice for already defined customer. We select the customer. If the customer is a credit customer, then its credit limit will be displayed and the amount which is yet to be received from the customer will be displayed. Now we load the items. And we go to the payment screen. Now in this case, all the amount, since this is a credit customer, is shown as a credit amount. When we save this invoice, the amount will go to the customer ledger. There is another button on this screen, which is return button. If we want to have some items returned in this invoice, we press this button and after this, whatever item we enter will be added as negative or being returned. So the net invoice can be processed in the same way by pressing the payment button. Another option on this screen is the hold help. When we click this and bring up the item list, when we are entering, it will not close. We enter all the items, then we press escape button or press this cross and all the items are loaded. Another option is the void. We can remove any item by pressing the void button. Its effect is removed, but it remains in the system. And then we can process in the same way. While we are making a new customer invoice, we can change the invoice date also if we want. On the sale and return screen, there is a related operations menu, which means all the screens which are related to sale and return are displayed here. And we can quickly navigate to those screens and also come back. There is another feature of adjustment. If we want to make changes to the net total, we can change the net total amount by entering adjustment. we can enter a positive or a negative value here. Usually, if the discount is given by the cashier, it's in percentage. So for doing this, we can press, while the focus is in adjustment, we can press F1. We will have the pop-up and press enter the adjustment percentage. So 10%, the system will automatically calculate the amount equal to 10% and rest will be displayed. If we have already made an invoice, we want to delete it, then the option for this is void. We can press void and this will remove the effect from the system. We can go to search and see that the invoice is strike through, which means it's void and we cannot do anything further with it. While making an invoice, if the customer leaves for some other items, we can put the invoice on hold so that we can process other customers. For this, we press hold. The data will be cleared and we are free to process other customer. When the customer returns, we click this. All the held invoices are displayed. We double click the required invoice and its data is loaded and we can proceed. If we want to discard it, we can just press the cross button.